self in Python is like this in Java, except self is not a keyword and can be replaced with any other word. Now, but you should not replace it. Now we have got our class here, class student, and it has got two methods and both are instance method. What does instance method mean? Instance method means that the data members or the variables that are inside these methods, they have a separate copy for each object. And in this program, we are going to create two objects, student1 and student2. So what happens when we create two objects is that we get a memory allocated in the heap memory for each object, and inside the memory allocated for each object, there is memory allocated for each data member or variable. So the stu1 and stu2 refers to student1, student2. Okay, the blue circles means that these rectangles are for student name, and the yellow circles refer to the CGPA part. Okay, so for each student we have a name and a CGPA. Now when we want to create objects, we write the student1, student2. But what happens when we want to access the data field of, let's say, student1, the name and the CGPA of student1? How do we do that? So for that, what happens is that we have got two ways to handle it. The first is the long way. So in the long way, what we do is student.newEntry, student1, let me select this line. So this is the line we are talking about. Okay, student.newEntry, student1, Roshan, and 8.1. What happens here is that we are accessing the object memory location via the class name. So when we access it via the class name, that is with capital S and then student, this one. So this is the class name, as you can see here. When we access it through the class name, we need to specify the object. Whose data values, data members are to be modified or accessed, or whose methods are to be accessed. Okay, so for that we need to pass the object name explicitly, and hence we have to write student1 here. But there is a shorter way to do this. What if we call the function by the object name itself? Because these are instance methods, so the object has the instance method. So if we access the instance method by the function name itself, by the object name itself, that is student2.newEntry, we don't have to pass the name of the object again. In that case, we just pass the name and the CGPA. Okay, so but how does compiler know which name or CGPA to access or to modify? Because as we have seen here, we have got two names and two CGPAs. Okay, so for that, and the compiler has to be compatible with both kind of syntax, like student dot new entry, the first syntax, and object dot new entry, the second syntax. So for that, the need of self arises. So if we pass the name of the objects explicitly, then this name of the object gets assigned to self, and hence student1 will be the object whose name and CGPA will be accessed. Okay, so if we write student1 Roshan 8.1, then self here will be replaced by student1, or in better terms, self will point to student1 object. Okay, so this will be student1.studentName and student1.CGPA. Now if we do not pass the name of the object explicitly, what happens is that self points to the current calling object. Okay, so here the current calling object is student2, because student2 is calling this function. Okay, and we are not passing any other object in the parameter. So what happens is self points to student2, and in that case, this self.studentName becomes student2.studentName, and this becomes student2.cgpa. And similarly, the last two lines, student1.display and student2.display, what happens when we call student1.display? Since this display function is being called by student1, self will point to student1, and hence it will print self will become student1. So student1.studentName, and in the second line it will be student2.studentName. And when you see the output, the output reflects the same. The first is student one name and then student one CGPA, and similarly student two name and student two CGPA. So that is all for self keyword, if it is a keyword. That's all for this video. See you later.